Power Pivot is a powerful data analysis tool that's built into Excel. It allows you to go beyond the limitations of regular Excel spreadsheets and work with much larger and more complex datasets. It allows you to import vast amounts of data from various sources like databases, flat files, and even other Excel sheets, and it can handle millions of rows, unlike 1 million rows in Excel. You can create a centralized data model, where you can connect various tables like you do in databases. You can use DAX to define columns and measures and perform various calculations. And finally, you can create pivot tables and charts using these models in MS Excel. Today, we will explore all these features of Power Pivot in our tutorial. We have a database in MS Access file. It has following multiple tables. Let's open and view these tables in MS Access first. We will import these tables into the MS Excel Power Query, and then we will create a model. After creating the model, we will use that model to create a Power Pivot report. So let's go to MS Excel. Here, in the Data Tools, you have a Power Pivot window button. The first time you click this button, a prompt will ask you to enable data analysis add-ins. So just click on the Enable button to enable these add-ins. It will automatically open this Power Pivot windows, which we don't need right now. The add-ins that have been enabled can be found in the Developer tab, which you must enable as well, from the Customize ribbon window. Locate and click on the COM add-ins button. There are the add-ins that need enabling in order for Power Pivot to work. Now, go to the Customize ribbon window and enable the Power Pivot tab. Check the Power Pivot and click on the OK button. Now you have the Power Pivot tab, which you can use to create Power Pivot reports. If we click on the Manage button, it will open the Power Pivot window. We can use the From Database button to import data from MS Access. Select the database file you want to load. Enter username and password, if any. You can also test the connection to make sure it works. On the next page, you can either choose to select tables from a list or use a query to select data. Let's use the default option, in which case, we will be presented with a list of tables from which we can choose tables that we want to load. Let's select all tables from the list. You can also preview the selected table and automatically select the related tables. Selecting the related tables means that the tables connected to the highlighted table will be selected. However, we did not define any relationships in our database, therefore this feature is useless to us. Click on the Finish button to add all tables to Power Pivot for Excel. And here are all the tables we added from MS Access database. To create a data model, let's go to the diagram view. Here, we have all tables, which we can move around and rearrange in any way we feel convenient. Now connect all tables to the sales table using their ID columns. This process is also called data modeling. And this visual representation of this database is called a data model. We can go back to the data view at any time by pressing this data view button. We can also use DAX and add new columns as well. Let's add some columns into the sales table using DAX. Product table contains cost and price which we need in the sales table against each product. We can use the related function to import costs from product table in front of each product. Inside the related function, select the cost field from the product table. After entering the DAX function, press the Enter button to create the column. Now, change the title of the column to Cost. This is the cost of one unit of product, whereas there are more than one products as well in the sales table. Therefore, we must multiply this value with the number of units to calculate the total cost. You can ignore the table prefix if the reference column is within current table. Press Enter to update the cost column as per new DAX query. Similarly, add prices from the product table as well. And multiply those to number of units as well. Change the title of this column to Price. Now that we have cost and price of each sale, we can also calculate profit. Add a new column and subtract cost from price to calculate profit. Press Enter to create the column, and then change the title of this column to Profit. Now, let's create some reports from this database using Power Pivot. Go to the Home tab and click on the Pivot Table button there. Select New Worksheet and press OK. Add the Price, Cost, and Profit fields to the Values area. Change their titles to Price, Cost, and Profit. Change their data type to comma separated number with two decimal places. Let's create our first report of price, cost, and profit by location. Add the region, country, and city fields from location table to rows area. Remove all unnecessary cells before pivot table. Add freeze panes from view tab to keep the header rows and columns always visible. You can also choose any pivot table style you want from the list of predefined styles in the Design tab. You can also show and hide the subtotals of any category in the report. Let's rename this sheet to By Location. Delete Sheet 1. And create a copy of the sheet with pivot table. Replace the fields in rows area with the description field from gender table. Now you have price, cost, and profit by gender. We can rename the row labels in our reports to something appropriate. Again, create a copy of the sheet with pivot table. This time, replace the fields in rows with the description field in channel table. Now we have a table with price, cost, and profit by channel. In the same way, we can use existing reports to create more reports, like price, cost, and profit by product or by status. Create a copy of the sheet again, and remove cost and profit fields from values. Only price field should remain in the values area. We will use both rows area and the columns area to create a report. Rows area already has status field. Add category field from product table to the columns area. We now have sales data by product category and by status. From this report, we can tell which the total price of products and their status. Let's call this table sales and rename this sheet to by status and category. However, this report is not too informative, as most executives would want to know the number of products by their status instead of price. For that, we can remove the sales field from the values area and add the units field from the sales table to the values area. And we can rename it to sales. Better change the number format to comma separated format. Maybe number of units is better than sales here. Now we can tell how many units of which product category are out for delivery or processing. We can tell how many units are approved, shipped, returned, delivered, etc. You can also add charts based on these pivot tables by simply inserting charts while a pivot table is selected. And with this, we end our tutorial. Thanks for watching. We hope you liked our tutorial. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more insightful tutorials and updates.